Can I be in your video if I do something quirky?
Sure, bro. Then why not?
Can I be on YouTube?
No.
Nope.
I want to be on YouTube.
Yes. And not one of those videos, okay? I'm
Yes. I want to be public.
Yeah, I would like to be in your video. Thank you, bro. And I will be famous then.
Yeah, screenshot files.
Yeah, I want to be in it.
I mean, I don't care. I'm whichever way you want to do it. If you don't want me to be in it, if you want me to, I don't care.
There is a reason why you won't see any Omegle videos being made from this channel, and it's certainly not because I haven't tried it yet. And although it's been suggested and insisted by a good number of people, I still refuse to make them. Even if it grows my channel, well, here is the reason on why. It's very unlikely to see an Omegle video coming from me, so here it is.
When I first started streaming Omegle on December of 2019, it was a completely new venture of trying out this idea of streaming myself talking to strangers on the website while playing video games, just to see how well this is going to work. And although I had people that decided to check out my channel, there was no real growth coming from that. And I thought to myself, if I just kept trying out different games or try out other things, I might get better results. But even then, there was still no growth there. And then I had the idea to see if anybody live streams this website. And when I did looked it up, it turns out I wasn't the only one. However, no one was really doing it in the way that I was doing it, as playing video games and talking to these individuals is not something people on this website expect speak to. And over time, I discontinued the use of playing a video game in favor of just having myself being on instead. Although I've gained a little bit of better results, it was nowhere close to what I figured out in late November of 2020 that contributed to the new growth of my channel and the attention I was getting at the time. I've been able to have two people seeing each other on one screen and the other without any noticeable differences in image quality, and how I've been able to basically enter two different conversations without them knowing that they're really connected to me, and it's only a matter of time until I can just interrupt them, and depending on how they react, it's either it throws them off, they get scared, they get amused, they get shocked, or they flat out get startled, as well as several different reactions. And some even wants me to stay with them. And it's come to the point that I have to come up with a way for them to either leave or to decide which am I going to skip. And so I usually just have them to play rock, paper, scissors, or flip a coin. And whoever wins or lose, I either stay with them or I just skip and go on to however many different people until the call ends. In some instances, I had some people telling me their life stories and telling me stuff on people they met and experiences they have, and others like the reason why they're on Omegle and how I've made their day a little better. I'm very well aware on how some individuals can be really sensitive to certain words being used against them, and how they can be insecure when someone points them out. And when the other person sees that, they'll either attack them using their insecurities, or they'll probably might not want to talk to them. And rarely does anybody stay to help them out. And other times, I had other individuals that aren't very welcoming, I should say, saying a lot of terrible things, including the use of racial slurs, in which I usually just skip. And other instances, some other individuals try to locate my IP to tell what location I'm in, only for them to realize that they only got the one that's connected to the VPN I'm connected to, and not the actual person's IP address, protecting their real location from that individual. I've slowly gained recognition and gained a little bit more as I've made a couple of appearances on someone else's live stream with subscribers with a larger sub count than mine's at the time. In some cases, you can even see what tags they're on, as most of them either completely forget to cover them or they go on tags that are overpopulated, making it nearly difficult to come across. But then what do you expect when the tag you want to go with has more people than any other? There definitely isn't any shortage of Omegle content being uploaded every day, as hundreds of videos and live streams get seen whenever the search results kicks in which the view count ends with either a K or some instances an M at the end. Usually the first results, before any other, could have a chance in the spotlight, unless specified otherwise. In which the majority of these so-called videos recording someone else's conversation or try to either tell funny jokes, performing some kind of social experiment, or flat out harassing individuals in order to get a reaction, as a large majority consists of females being shown on the thumbnails in most of these videos, in by no doubt ranks in clicks and a decent amount of views, with clickbait titles enticing the viewer to watch till the end, in which I personally am not a big fan of. And yet, it most certainly does appeal to a certain demographic, no doubt. I just don't see myself making shorter videos of my streams whenever I finish one to re-upload, as video editing takes a lot of time. And the fact that I haven't been releasing that many videos, much like this one, and the many times I had to go on Omegle to record from different periods of the number of times I went on that site, without the incentive of recording anything, usually. There were countless people on Omegle, and they all keep telling me to make funny reaction jump scares, much like what the other content creators make of this genre. And since I happen to be on Omegle a lot, they most likely expect me to make that kind of content. However, the truth of the matter is, this channel wasn't really meant to be solely for Omegle only. Although it has helped me gain quite a following, and that's how most of you have found out about my channel, but it was never really the direction this channel was meant to go. From the way I see it, sometimes you kind of have to do something that just works before you can do the other thing that you really want to do. So to an extent, I kind of had to cater to a certain demographic, but at the same time, branch out to doing other things without alienating my existing audience. And so I'll still be able to do Omegle content in the form of live stream, in which I believe they are better when it's done live, in my opinion. So there's a good chance that Omegle streams will be a little less frequent, and I'll be focusing more on the things that I really want to work on. Even if I have to get on Omegle to demonstrate my talents and whatnot, like I have before, until Omegle no longer becomes the only thing I can rely on to get the word out. So as of those different type of content that I have planned to work on, those usually take a very long time to work on, and they take a lot of time to put together, edit them, finalize, and upload, as the majority of the time I'm either working, or I'm doing other things, or I'm too exhausted to work on some of these projects, making it pretty difficult to really get them going. And other factors like the software I use may not be enough for what I plan to do, and I may have to use another thing entirely. Or I just lack the skills I need in order to make these videos more effective. But for now, I'm only going to work with what I have until a better solution comes up. Till then, this is LR7, not making Omegle videos like the ones you've seen, and logging out.
Side note, there was actually a lot more that happened that I forgot to bring up, so I'll mention it in another video or during a live stream. So yeah.